Ma'am, what is this Jan Manch about? I understand about 100 NGOs have come together to...
About 200 NGOs, the Suchna Rozgar Abhiyan. It's a campaign which was born out of a concern about employment and information rights many years ago. But we have come together on all kinds of democratic rights. So we demand that before an election, actually, that we know exactly what we are doing, why we are going to vote for a candidate. So we call the candidates to a platform and we ask them to tell us exactly what they intend to do. Today, unfortunately, it's much too close to the election. But in most of the cities, either the party representatives or the candidates themselves have come and explained what they intend to do if they win. So that it's not only the manifesto, it's also their personal affirmation about what they intend to do for that particular area. And they have also been questioned on very many specific issues. And they have given answers which we will remember, even if they don't remember. So if they win, we will be at their doorstep.
आप बताइए सरकार और सत्ता में फर्क है क्या आई आप तो बात करना चाह रहे थे आई सरकार और सत्ता में फर्क है क्या
हाँ मुझे लगता है कि काफी फर्क है कि सरकार नाम की रह गई क्योंकि उनको पूंजीपति चलाते हैं ज्यादातर तो बहुत उनके घर पे बैठे रहते हैं चाय वाई पीते हैं और सत्ता जिनके पास है सही लोगों के हाथ में नहीं है सत्ता गुंडे बाहुबल दादा कैसे जितने भी एमएलए एमपी नेता मुख्यमंत्री ये हैं अपने भारत के अंदर अभी एक रिपोर्ट भी आई थी कि ज़्यादातर पे केसेज हैं किसी पे बलात्कार का केस है किसी पे क्या है तो उन्हें हम थोड़ी देर के लिए मान सकते हैं कि उनके पास सत्ता है और उन्होंने शायद उसका गलत उपयोग किया है
And then elections happened and he was blaming the NGOs for starting a kind of campaign against him. And now it's said that NGOs have all come together to destabilize Vasundhara government.
We have not come to destabilize anybody. We have come to assert the rights of people. We have assert democratic rights to be heard, democratic rights to be heard by our politicians who are actually our representatives. We are bigger than they are. We are the sovereigns. They just go there to represent our rights. None of them have behaved in a manner in which we are treated as equals. We haven't got a single meeting with the chief minister, despite the fact that Shankar was beaten up in her constituency by her MLA and his arm has been injured. Despite that, proof that he has actually beaten Shankar up, we appealed to her so many times, she didn't see us. Now, if our representatives refuse to meet us, we are in a state of electoral democratic emergency, which means that we are being ruled by people who only want our vote, and after that they don't care less what happens to us. This is not how a democracy should run. So if any party comes to power, that party's first job is to listen to its people, is to listen to its voters, to understand their conditions and their plights. They don't go to rule, they go to govern. And there's a great deal of difference between ruling and governing. Governance means adherence to constitutional values, it means understanding the rights of individuals, it means listening to people, it means addressing their problems.
Ma'am, yesterday the Chief Minister said the opposition accused her of being a Maharani, but she is somebody who serves the people all the time. She cited a lot of her campaigns.
Anyone can say anything, but the record of the last 5 years or the record of her performance will show what she has done. And we all evaluate her. We are all intelligent people. We are not carried away by speeches. So we will look at the record sheet. And the record sheet, whatever it says to us, we will go by that.
Is it limited to this election only, or are you going to
expand
it?
No, we have been doing it for the last 4 elections. In fact, that's how we got the right to information, that's how we got the employment guarantee. We've been doing it for many elections. This is not the first election we're doing.